There's the first shredding. If you look down in the bucket here, it looks pretty ground up, actually looks pretty good. There's some extra stuff in there. I was testing this out before I started doing the video to make sure it would go. Now, the one thing I do have to say is that my drill show you guys this here is pretty warm. Even this handle here is pretty warm to touch, so it's definitely taking a beating on the drill here. This part up here is actually not too bad, but in here, especially in the back here, it's pretty warm. So running it like that really does wear down your drill. But overall, I'm gonna have to dump some water through this now to see if we can clear this out. It looks like this is holding up on the side here. So it looks like it's holding up pretty well. This was a lot of frozen fruit and some fresh fruit too, and stuff that I'd thawed out. So I had some frozen and thawed banana peels. I had melon, I had avocado shells. I had some asparagus that was thrown in there and some carrot tops. So that was a good first run for this. Let me add that food to the bin. Let me wash this out. Let me show you how I'm gonna do that too. So let's go wash this out first. All right, so I've got my bucket underneath here still. And now it's time to clean this. So I'm gonna hook this back up. I'm gonna keep this low though, really low. I don't really want it to go fast. The idea is just to be able to kind of rinse everything off. So even though the drill is still a little warm, I'm going to put it right back on here. Let me get the battery in. It's really just to rotate. I'm going to take, I've got just a container of water here. I'm going to pour just a little bit of it through here just to try to rinse everything out. And as you can see, there's a little bit more coming through. You just get this back side here. All right, I think it looks good enough for now. Now remember, I don't want to stick my fingers in there while it's running. So we're going to pop the battery out and we're going to say that this is pretty clean. I'll probably take it out one more time outside maybe and spray it down with a hose just to get a little bit more. I don't want to add too much water in here. But, or you could just do that. I just want to clear out the big chunks before I take it outside. All right, I'm outside here. Got my hose. I'm just going to hose this thing down. All right, I'm kind of holding this off. Like you can see, this is just going to clean it all out. Then I'm going to put the hose down, back up here, kind of rotate a little bit. More hose water in here. Just really try to rinse it all out. Again, rotate one more time. And there we go, this is nice and clean. It doesn't take long to clean, it's not hard. It might be a little harder when it's you know, cold outside. I won't be able to do this quite as well, but that's how you can clean it out real quick. No reason to really take a whole lot of time cleaning it. And let's head back inside and I can show you the grounds that we got out of this. Okay, so here we are with the scraps that came out of here. And these are nicely ground up scraps, really. So this is good stuff to add to a bin or container. So this is what I wanted to see. I mean, you can see there's still some big chunks that made it through. You know, this is a big chunk of melon. This is actually frozen pretty much, so that's probably why it just broke through. I mean, it's really still pretty frozen. But other than that, and I put some stuff through even before I started filming. And this is all broken down into much smaller chunks than what went in. I actually did have a full head of lettuce that went in that I somehow missed recording. The only thing I won't do again probably is I probably won't put the water in here. I also had some lemon peels that went through. They kind of just got squeezed. They didn't really chop up too much, you know, so. But overall, it did work really well. This is now ready to go into one of my bins, which is my next video that I'm going to do right now is going to be. So in closing, this works. My shredder here that I've got off to works. So I've got it right here. It works really well. Oh, let me pull a couple pieces, chunks out of there. I'm going to have to figure out a couple different things. One, I'm going to have to figure out a better way to mount it to this table here, or some other way to mount it, because it was able to twist its way out. So I'll have to figure that out. I'm not sure exactly what to do yet, but I'll have to figure something out to hold it better into this table. And I might have to switch out my drill with a different one. It began to really get hot. I do have a couple others, but I'm worried about too much torque on this nut down here. I have a major drill driver here, but I don't want to shred this thing apart immediately just because of the fact of how much torque it can put in. So I might have to find a way to reduce the amount of torque so it doesn't rip this apart. But overall, it is working. I'll have to try to find a better way to set it up. But I will keep going with this, and we're going to keep getting more and more of this type of shredded material to put in my bins. And then eventually my goal is to shred up a whole lot and actually do a vermenting bucket that Eve from, or Mark from Eve Growing does. So he sent me actually these buckets to try it out. I haven't set it up yet, and I feel a little guilty since he got these down here. So I'm going to get that set up. But my first goal is to start chopping some of this stuff up into a much finer material than some of the big chunks that I have, so that way it can really disappear a little bit better and be worked at better. So that's it for this week. I will, again, probably do more shredding in the coming weeks, and I will try to record all the shredding I'm doing, so that way you can see how this works and whether you want to build one or not. So thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe to my videos, and I hope you enjoyed this.